Tonight's performance. The title of this program is New Music for Flexible Ensemble. There's only one piece on the program that wasn't written in the past 10 years. And this summer, we were kind of dealing with the COVID and with the College Band Directors National Association. They've been doing a lot of things related to COVID, and the idea of doing flexible pieces came up in the summer of 2020 because we all didn't know, are we going to be able to get a full group together or not? And so the idea of having maybe 5 or 6 parts that can be played by a bunch of different people. That was a new thing for really difficult pieces of music. And the piece that we just played, Dancing Fire by Kevin Day, was originally a full band piece in 2016, and a band director slash composer rearranged it for a smaller group of instruments. So we had the opportunity to apply to perform at the Southern Division Conference that's going to be this week in Columbia, South Carolina. I had the idea, the proposal to do a whole bunch of these pieces together and to do a lot of brand new pieces of music. The next piece is by Olivia Kiefer, and she's a current doctorate student at Miami, as well as Kevin Day, who wrote the last piece. And we did the full band version of this in November. So those of us, I know that we have some groupies out there. Some of you follow me on Facebook and things like that. But it's very different. Some of the students, they didn't have the same parts this time as they did before. And so it's a really neat piece. This is a minimalist piece, kind of based very much on the music of Philip Glass. So if you know the music of Philip Glass, you're going to hear some of that style in this piece of music. Next up is And Then the Universe Exploded. Thank you. The next piece on the program is a movement from a piece called Du Danses Fantastiques. And the composer is Wen Choke, and we have the composer with us. He's going to give us a few words about this piece coming up.
Thank you very much. A lot of this program is very high-minded, you know, supernovas and universes exploding. Mine is on a very mundane subject of heartbreak, which I'm sure none of you know what that's about. As Dr. Ladd said, it's a set of two pieces. The second one still being written and is on the very lively subject of Bulgarian dance, which if you know anything about that is wild and crazy. But this piece was written after a very sad romantic situation, and this, I would say, represents the time when all of the deep grief has come and gone. And now it's a matter of resigning gracefully, let's say, a very quiet farewell to something that was. So there's a very bittersweet aspect to it, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Gwen and I first met. We were roommates, freshman roommates in college, and we spent we were at Eastman together for 5 years. Another person who went to Eastman, Eastman School of Music with us is Matt First, another pianist slash composer. And you couldn't get two more different pieces next to each other, despite the fact they went to the same school and they have both have piano performance degrees from Eastman. Matt went to Eastman for his undergrad, and they got a master's and a doctorate in composition at Juilliard. He's had performances by New York City Ballet, and we were fraternity brothers, Phi Mu Alpha. There are some Phi Mu Alpha here, people here. And we met each other through the fraternity, and he's one of my favorite people. One of those people, you know, like I called him to ask him if I could do this piece, if I could arrange this piece for the group that we have. It was just so great to hear his voice. You know, I hadn't heard him in ages, and especially now with COVID, you know, you just, it's so important to make those connections. So this piece is short, and it's got a lot of energy. And he based it on the mathematics of the star, the specific star, how it became a black hole, basically. And this is just a 2 minute and 20 or 30 second description astronomical event. I should learn how to speak. I got 4 college degrees and a doctorate. Come on, man. So I hope you enjoy this piece. It's a wild ride. Thank you.
Hello. Good evening. It's so great to, I can't really see because of the lights, but it's so great to see you all here. This is a very exciting opportunity for us. I know that Dr. Ladd, at the beginning of this concert, explained that we were going to this conference, but this is such a huge deal for us. So I want to thank him for moving the wind ensemble, moving this department forward like this, and for including me on this project, first and foremost. Back in October, when he said he was putting together a proposal to be included on this concert, he asked me if I wanted or if I'd be willing to write a piece that would go along with this. It had to be flex ensemble, so you see that this is a smaller ensemble than what you might normally see with a concert band. And he asked me for something significant, multi-movement, 15 minutes. And I think we had that conversation in like early October, let's just say like October 1st or something. And he got accepted, we got accepted on October 15th. I was like, I got a lot of music to write. But before we did that, in order to put the proposal together, I had to come up with, you know, what is this piece gonna be about? And, you know, the last few years, for obvious reasons for all of us, things have been a bit chaotic. This idea of chaos came into my mind about, you know, how can we put this into music? And so that's what I set about doing. And it's not just in a single way, as I think we all are aware of. So the opening movement, the prelude, kind of just sets the tone for the chaos that's to come. And then the second movement is titled The Greater Good. It's about how there's this abstract enemy, the coronavirus that we're all dealing with. And we should all band together and kind of deal with it together, right? But there's conflict that goes on in how we each individually think we should deal with this. And we're still dealing with this. Luckily, though, we get to take these masks off here at Nicholls tomorrow. We got that email earlier today. But like I said, we thought we were done with this in the fall. At least I did. And then it came right back. So we might just have to deal with this together forever. We don't know. But that's the idea of the second movement, is the greater good. The third movement, Restoration, is more, you know, I wrote this piece to where people could apply to their own lives. But the way that I apply it is, I was thinking of after Hurricane Ida, when you come back to a devastated area, especially after a hurricane, it's like the weather is bizarrely nice, and it's just like the devastation is you just look at it, it's like there's so much work to do, there's so much to see as far as, you know, how devastated is this area. So that's what I thought when I wrote that piece, is that it's very quiet at first. You can kind of feel the desolation, and then this idea of a community coming together to has a common good to put things back together. That's what I think of for that third movement. And then the fourth movement, titled Noncompliance, is about just sometimes there are authority figures, political figures, etc., that need to be stood up against. And even though it's not right to do so, sometimes it's good to make good trouble. And that's kind of what I was thinking for that fourth movement. So it's a little more aggressive. It's a little bit more about facing a man-made enemy. So this is Confronting Chaos. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
the next piece on the program is by somebody I've known for a really long time. And I was excited to write this piece. I started some ideas of it about 2 or 3 years ago, and I felt like I couldn't quite start working on it. I felt kind of uneasy about it, but I decided to start with the last movement. So it's this is coming up as a trumpet concerto, and the third movement, I decided I knew how I wanted to end the concerto, and it is about authoritarianism and kind of what are we even doing here? Kind of like stupidity and repetition about things that I think that could be fixed that aren't, like potholes and all kinds of little things, but also societal things, bigger picture things, that if we just worked together, and it comes back, I think, to what Ben was talking about in his piece. I think ultimately if we work together, we have more in common together than we do otherwise. And one of the things I feel really fortunate, we have some great faculty here. If you look at our bios, we have doctorates from places all across the country. And I can't think of, it's very rare to have a trumpet player study with the people that Dr. Swire has studied with. And I feel really fortunate. We got here at the same time. This is our 7th year at Nicholls. Excellent musicians, played and subbed with the Seattle Symphony, the Louisiana Philharmonic, and studied with do we all know the sleigh ride, the horse sound? That was started by a trumpet player named Gitala, and that was one of Dr. Swihart's teachers. So that's how cool his bio is. So I'd like to welcome Dr. Swihart to the stage to play this trumpet concerto. This Allegro, the last movement of the trumpet concerto by... Thank you all for being here, for supporting these students. I want to acknowledge a few people. I want to start, you may not be aware of this, but a number of the best band programs in the state of Louisiana are in Terrebonne and Lafourche Parish. And so without the hard work of those band directors, this group wouldn't be possible. And I especially want to thank, there are 19 students on stage. They came in a week before classes started. We started actually playing some of this stuff in November. And they put in a lot of time. Some of these same students are the ones who went to Lafayette when Nicholls campus was closed. And I really want to give a round of applause to the students for all the work that they've done. We're getting on a bus, and the Beatles go round and round on the bus. We're gonna leave at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, so if you have something negative to say to these people, please don't do that between now and then. We all did COVID tests yesterday, so we're in fantastic shape to go. And we're really excited to showcase the music department, the College of Liberal Arts, and also the university to band directors from across the southern United States. The last piece on the program actually received its world premiere here in March 2018. Another good friend of mine, Kimberly Archer, we went to Syracuse together, and we were talking, and she wanted me to do a consortium. And out of that consortium was a five-movement piece called American Labor Songs. And when I was doing this proposal, like Ben was saying, she was one of the people I said, it'd be great to do part of that piece, because I think this piece, it'd be great to have a flex version in case people can't get a band together, but I think that more people should play this piece. And one of the things that's happened since we premiered her piece here and now is that she was commissioned to write a piece for the United States Marine Band for the presidential inauguration. So her trajectory has kind of skyrocketed in the last year or two, and she's a hard worker, fantastic musician, and she's been to Thibodaux. She likes it here. If you want to create a job for her, I'm sure she'd be willing to move down here. It's snowy and stuff in Illinois. But we're going to play the first movement of the American Labor Songs. Thank you so much for your support, and go Colonels.
Thank you.